Hello there, everyone. This is Mark 3 and welcome back to Astroneer in this, the odd tableau. I think it's tableau. Yeah, tableau, which is set by the exotic world. It's still a very odd place. Dawn is threatening, so I figured this would be a good time to start recording and trying to figure out what the heck I'm going to do, because honestly, this odd terrain, it... how the heck am I going to explore this place, and how am I going to build a base, and did I just land in a bad spot? But I also don't recognise that research type over there, so that also gives me something to start out with. Anyway, let us begin. I'm not packing any of the titanium, the resin on me, so I'm just going to extend out the side here. Okay, that's one. I need a printer, I need research, I need a whole bunch of bits and pieces. Yeah, the only way I can do this is to drop down into the floor below me, I think. But I can put something to my side here. Let's pop another one there. Okay, that's my first thingy. Now, you are going to be... actually, I'm okay with you being the printer, to be quite honest. Yeah, printer's fine. That means I'm going to use some copper to get you up. Okay. Copper. Get you built. Next one, extend over here. This is why I tried to stock up on resin before I departed my previous location. Because I figured I was going to need a whole bunch of stuff to extend platforms, but I didn't realise it'd be quite this bad, to be quite honest. Oh dear. The floating base. Yes, definitely. The floating base, indeed. Well, this is going to be fun, isn't it? How am I going to work this thing? Okay. Yeah, this base is going to be all over the darn place. Okay, I need to get a trade platform up. That's much as obvious to me, so... actually, I want that to be the research one, don't I? Ah... I've already used up one of my stacks of resin. This is going well. Actually, let's make you the trade platform. And extend... oop, almost fell off. You can extend as well. I want you to be actually the research, now that I think about it. Oh no, actually, you can be the research and you can be the trade platform. Changed my mind already. Excellent start. And I didn't bring enough resin, that's why I wanted the trade platform up. Now, where's my aluminium? Here we go. Aluminium. Compounds. Sure, get the research up and running, though I don't have any power for it yet. Aluminium, yep. Might as well just dump that in there. Research! Within easy access to both of the base. I must admit, I am actually kind of intrigued by this entire situation. I'm very intrigued by this planet, though... if it will continue to live up to expectations as a completely weird place, I honestly couldn't say, because I have no idea if that will be the case or not. All I know is that I made a slight mistake by having zero power available. So yes, that is actually a thing. What I need is resin, which is... nope! Bugger. I was trying to click the arrow and I accidentally sent it into space. Fine. Sure. Also zero power, which means I need to get. I didn't figure on this. I didn't figure to bring. Oh, power cells. Yeah, that'll do. That'll do the trick. A batch of power cells. Sure. I'll just dump them straight into here. That should be enough to get this thing operational, I think. And if I put some compound into here... So that'll provide... A single power cell provides 4 bars of power. Okay, that's good. Hello, trade thing, which I accidentally sent off. I didn't mean to send you. Oops. Didn't mean to put that on there either. I'll probably need the resin, to be quite honest. What I actually need, though, is wind power as well, and then I need the battery. So it's just getting this first base started up. For all the preparation I did in the last video, I actually forgot to account for the fact that I need to power it all, so... Whoops. My bad there. It was an honest mistake. I seem to make a lot of mistakes, though. Trade. Yep. Wind platform. Do I have a spot where it'll work? Can't put it on there because that's a trade platform, and they don't work properly on that. It's flipping. Honestly, this does irritate me. How the wind turbines aren't reliable. Like, at all. I've got nowhere I can put it to actually work. That sucks. Very much so. Oh well, let's get this other platform extending out then. Sure. And... Yeah, the game doesn't know what to do about it either, so it's just building this big floating base in the air. Sure. Why not? Oh well, if it's going to do that, we might as well just let it do that. The smelter, this will be the vehicle bay, which needs some more aluminium. Sure. I've still got aluminium, but though I didn't, it's not lasting as long as I thought it would, because I thought I'd have enough aluminium to get, you know, set up. And get a vehicle out, but I only brought 8, and I've spent 6. So, yeah. Oh, it works on that one. Okay, good. Sure. There is that, then, I suppose. Then I also lastly need the battery power to store it. Now the thing is, I've got to leave this base to charge up a bit while I'm waiting. Or I could just build a power generator and use some coal. Problem is, I still don't like the power generator because it runs on coal, so, you know. I'm biased on that, I'm afraid to say. At least I've got some renewable power going on. Actually, a generator with coal would probably be a really good idea. But let's actually get this thing evened out a bit. So I don't have holes in the middle of my base that I'm going to fall down, because that is definitely going to happen if I leave it as it is. The wonders of base design. Now then, this thing will build vehicles on its own little platform there. Okay. Oh, there's that one that I don't recognise over there. That's convenient. Actually, this does look slightly familiar, but not entirely sure. Oh well, let's put that in, and I might as well get the flipping generator up. Or I would if I had power. I don't have power. Ah. What are you giving me? You give me some copper, and that's okay. Don't really need it, but sure. I'll put that copper into there. Put that into there. Okay. I hear a storm, I think. Yep. Same sound effect, same storm thing. That's all that it ever does. And the flipping wind turbine has stopped even with the storm coming in. Oh. Hooray for consistency, I suppose. Seriously, that just irritates me so much. Having to move your darn wind turbines when they stop working just to get a bit of power. Fine, just give me a flipping generator for my copper stores. It's going to be a darn sight more reliable because I don't have much by way of solar powers or anything like that. So let's do this. Man, you're coming on really slowly, aren't you? You're a very slow mover compared to the storms on the other planets. Because I can actually see stuff. Now, what I want is coal. Since this is a bigger generator, I want coal. This is probably going to be the first time I've actually fired up this particular generator, because I've never used one before. I just looked at it and said, oh, it uses coal, that's bad. And then said, nope, I'm not even going to try it. What's going on? That's storm. I think it came towards me and then it changed direction. I have never seen one do that before. Seriously, I've never seen one do that before. One coal. Sure. A couple of copper and titanium. I'll go for that. And don't... Yep. Wind power stopped again. Hooray. Freaking thing. On the right side, at least it's working over there again. So, there is that. But still. That irritates me so much. Now these big white ones, are they actually a formable one? No, they are actually immobile, can't do a thing with them, so... Joy. Honestly, this feels really awkward just trying to set up a base out here. I expected I'd be done by now, but I'm worrying so much about how I'm trying to build it, so... Yeah. Maybe I should have just relaunched and tried to find a different place, I don't know. Anyway, power. Give me power. Research this odd stone box, see if there's actually anything in it. Oh, hydrogen, sure. Not what I wanted, but a bit of fuel. Welcome. Are there any others around here that I don't recognise? I don't think there was. I think that was the only one. Yeah, all the others are familiar to me. And is that still burning the coal? Yes, I think it is. Darn it. Okay, that means I need to start burning power. Just as well, really, because I need to do a lot of stuff anyway, so... Because I need ways to move, I need ways to get down, I need ways to... get a vehicle down off this ramp, and... into this... I'm not going to be able to get a vehicle through here, actually. I'm not. But I do need a way down. So, yeah. My plan to go out with a vehicle is looking like a bit of a wash at this point. I just can't explore with... Oh, look! Suddenly there's a whole load of plant life and things generating. Hooray. And suddenly I'm generating organic because of my efforts to reshape the terrain. Hooray! This world is doing wonders for my sanity. Yes, it is. Oh yeah, I've got a bit of titanium on there, I forgot. I don't know, I'm very rapidly developing a love-hate relationship with this world, I must admit. Oh, a bit of lithium. Ooh, fancy. Was there anything else nearby? That was that one down there. And yeah, look, I've wasted most of that coal because I didn't have the storage to use it, and I wasn't using power suddenly when I plugged it in, so... That's why I don't like these generators, the big ones. They burn a resource and then they don't give you much for it. Yeah, I think trying to build the base up here was a bit of a mistake. Oh well, too late to do much about it. Just need a way down. Well, way down is easy. I can just jump off the side. That would be a way down, wouldn't it? No, what I need is a way to get back up. So that's what I'm doing here. Or at least trying to. Yeah, that'll do. And I need some tethers so I can actually go out here and explore a bit. I don't have an onboard power source since I left those behind, but okay. Sure, okay, let's get some... Oh yeah, it's on power cells. Whoops. Sure, I just wasted a bit more stuff. Let's go down here and start wandering around. Exploration ho! It's a dead end. Oh, there's some minerals down here. Okay. If nothing else, that previous world has taught me to look for stuff buried, so... Why couldn't I dig that? What is that anyway? Oh, that's hydrazine. That's useful. Okay. That's a hydrogen deposit there. Yeah, that other world taught me to look for stuff buried just under the surface because, you know, all the stuff on that world was buried under the surface, to be quite honest. Oops. Now, the thing is, I know that this one's going to be just a material, so... I'm just carting it back because reasons. Don't really need it. Might as well put that there, refill my oxygen, and then drop off the side here. Whee! Ow. Actually, that is an interesting thought. This place would be... What if this place was like... full of low-hanging gas or something? That would be quite spooky to look at, I think. And what the heck are these ones? I don't recognise these ones. Oh wait, yes I do. They're just on their side. It's the same one as before. I just didn't recognise the plugs on it because they were sideways. So leave you there. Don't really care about you. Still, this is really cool though. Oh, I can't seem to make up his mind. But is this a cave system that's appeared just up on the surface or something? I don't know. It's very winding though. Lots and lots of ways to get lost in here if it wasn't for the beacons for your base. Wait, what's that? Oh. It looks like it was a really small research item there, so I was just wondering what it was, and it's one of those big mineral boxes. So, okay. And that is plants. I think that's more hydrogen, isn't it? Along with our guarding set of nasty acid spitters. So very quickly deal with those. Don't care about your research. Go away. Oh, it's copper. Nope, I better run before I die. Yeah, that's important. Run away. Oh, oxygen. I hear another storm coming in. This is going great so far. Where's my access point? It's around here, I think. Oh, I wasn't even at the base. Here we go. Since there's a storm coming in, I'm going to put down some tethers for a tether connection. And then I'm just going to start indulging my troglodyte imperatives for this world. Since I'm finding this entire place a bit confusing to navigate, definitely no way in hell I can get a vehicle out of here. I mean, seriously, no way in hell. So I'm going to start digging here and see if I can hit something underground. Yeah, this is a good spot, I guess. As good as any other. Down we go. Okay. Now, I mentioned last time that that I was thinking of ending the series if I couldn't think of anything else to do. Because otherwise it would just be me blindly wandering around, babbling into a recorder. And that is still very much true, so... Yeah, if you guys think of something for me to do, then let me know. And if I think it's interesting, I'll do it on the videos, but... Yeah, quite honestly, this game is as much about exploration as anything else, and right now that's all that's left, and it'll be all finding the same stuff. So that investigating these other planets really is the last thing I could think of that I thought would be good for making video content and stuff like that. So yeah. What should I replace it with though? Because there is something else coming out pretty soon, which is... what is it? Damn it, I've forgotten the name. Basically, it's a simulation game where you become mayor. It's actually due out... what's the date? It's due out tomorrow, actually. And I'm quite interested in getting that. And what I'm thinking of is doing a recording of it where I am the... Hello, Cave. Excellent. I was looking for you. I'm thinking of doing a run on it, recording where I am the biggest absolute bastard, in the most literal sense of the word, to ever... disgrace the face of the planet. So yeah, political corruption for the win. Just to see what it's like, because if it was me, I'd be trying to get along with people more often than not, and stuff like that, and this is actually a really small cave, isn't it? That's not promising that. I'll put a tether like this for easy use. And let's take a quick look, see. Oh yeah, this is very narrow. Doesn't help that I've intercepted basically a narrow tunnel, as it is. I've not seen many tunnels as narrow as this, so let's take a look and see. Let's have a gander. Very narrow, very winding. Yeah, the caves on the irradiated planet were very wide open. The caves on the starting planet were actually fairly large as well, but this place is more of a very narrow maze-like quality to it, I think. At least this section of it. Maybe I've just been unlucky where I landed. I don't know. Because I do think I've been unlucky where I landed as far as... power. Yeah. Because my landing site was definitely a bad one. But these caves... If they're like this, I might not bother exploring them that much. Which means that entire base and the last 20 minutes are a bit of a waste. Oh joy. And that means also I'll need to do some gathering of materials and things as well. Should I bother gathering the rest of this malachite? Well, ultimately I need to trade for materials to actually get, you know, replace the supplies I've used. So I do need to do some harvesting. That's... the way and the truth of it. I need to harvest to replace what I've used up. Oh, can't quite get through here. I'll pop that there. Come on, it's saying you're in range. There we go. Okay. Right. Yeah. This is not actually that promising. If you came to see someone just getting lost underground, there's many other things you could do. But honestly, I'm not even getting lost, really. I just hope there's not gigantic worms running around in these tunnels, which are going to probably munch my face off or something. Oh, hello. A slightly larger area. Oh, hello, I'm exposed to the surface here. Oh, and I almost fell down that hole there. Yeah, the cave system is more expansive. That's good. But my initial concerns are looking quite well-founded. Oh dear. I think this world's cave systems really are really long, really thin, really narrow things. Ow. Which means that exploring and finding good places to look at and... seeing what they're like is going to prove a problem. I think maybe a better approach would be if I refitted my spaceship as a kind of mobile base rather than trying to use it to found an outpost like I have on this particular trip. Yeah, that sounds like a good idea, actually. Oh, no, I don't have any compounds, so I have to go back now. Right, okay, sure, fine. I am disappointed, quite honestly, because I was hoping for something different here, but end of the day, rules of cave formation are rules of cave formation, so there's only so much variety you can have in those, unfortunately. I guess it's because there's not much fauna and flora and stuff. Once that comes into the game more, these caves will have much more diversity in them. But this is not tickling my fancy all that much. Not really. Yeah, it's just long tubes underground. Oh, hello. Oh. Hello. Apparently there are some big caves here. Oh, and there's a poison gas pit I just saw at the edge there. Okay, I'm going to go grab compound and come back down here. Check this cave out at least, because this cave does look pretty good. I'm glad to see it, actually, because as you've seen up until this point, it's just been all these really narrow passages and things. But laying out my resources to put out a big outpost, definitely a mistake. Compound for tethers, onboard power generation, onboard power storage. For the most part, that is going to be enough to see me by on these exploration trips. I don't need to bother massively restocking myself between journeys. Did I build the smeltery? Yes, I did. There it is. Okay. A smeltery that is actually able to function at full capacity. I am also a bit sore about... you can probably tell, I'm a bit sore about how the one on the last planet got clogged up by excess minerals. Ooh, a bit of titanium. That's a bit of luck. Okay. Now, I need compound here. And I... Yep, I just wasted some of that, yep. Another problem with the smeltery, it just wasted that, copper it worked through, so, yep. That copper is gone into oblivion. Joy. I'm finding all the things to complain about today, aren't I? Yeah, I am. Wow. Grab that, yep. Grab that one, yep. Grab that there, yep. Put this solar panel down onto that, because I want to pick up an aluminium. Yeah, I think I should keep a small stock so I can get some initial buildings down if I feel the need to expand an outpost, but... Yeah, for the most part, don't bother. I think it's probably the rule of thumb I'm going to follow from here on out. The wind vane to give me power underground is a good idea, I think. There we go, yep. Tethers. I want to bring some more with me so I can wander around without having to come back up. And then once I've exhausted my compound supply a bit... Actually, I've got enough for... Yeah, oh, that's going to be plenty. Sure. Let's quickly head underground and take a quick initial look at that... outpost, and then this will hit just over half an hour, so that'll be the end of the episode here. Oops, Daisy. Oh, going down too quickly. I was getting hurt there. Also, my frame rate was plummeting, so yeah, that was also a thing. Anyway, I went this way, so it was this along here. Yeah, it's still peaceful, but the surface of this world was very exotic, very interesting. Also, an absolute nightmare. So that really caught my initial fancy, that's the surface of this world, but I'm hoping this cave system will be different. But so far it has not lived up to its initial first impressions. Not really. So, let's fingers crossed. Fingers crossed. And this is why I brought a whole bunch of compound along, because I knew I'd need a whole bunch of tethers to properly explore this place. I've also not really gotten any idea of mineral composition of this world either, and that was one of the other reasons I wanted to explore, to see what kind of stuff is around. I've got one more tether. Now let's start digging. That is either hydrazine or titanium, I don't know. Oh, I'm directly over a drop, so that's a good start, isn't it? Yep. Okay, let's equalise here. And this will be my roots down. Nah! Whoops. Flipping rock got in the way and messed up my terraforming. There's an alien thingy. Okay. It seems to have misspawned a little bit. Yeah, I can't tell what that mineral is. There's some aluminium ore in the background, though. That's excellent. I do need to replace my aluminium stocks, which I foolishly burned up. Hang on. Hematites? What? There's iron in them that are hills. Yes. Iron. Hematite? Do I actually need hematite for anything? What? I've not seen anything I actually need iron for. Why is it here? Is it a trade medium? Is that all it does? Also, I'm glad I built this bridge down, because I was really over a big passage there. Acid spitters, there's a big compound deposit up there in the roof as well, but hematite. Ow. Should probably even this out a bit more. Right. Even. There we go. And then I'll pop one. Oh, I'm out of tethers. Sure. Hematite. Huh. The heck? I'll just pop one here to clearly mark where I came in. Yep. Dig a passage across here. Since I'm about to make some really, really big holes. Yep. And then hematite. That looks very like the titanium ore, actually. Yeah, that looks like it's the same model as the titanium ore, but it's not. It's iron. The heck? Oh yeah, this is going to replace all the aluminium I used up, no problem. This is actually pretty iron-rich deposits, actually, but yeah. Exotic planet seems to be a good place to go if you're looking for minerals. Hematites. I'll just pop out quickly a tether pack here. And then I'm just going to leave it there. So I'll pick that up when I come back. Because I want to grab an extra slot of hematite. And I was planning to stop as soon as I had an initial look here, but these passages are actually pretty darn big. So, as one last thing to do for this video, because I'm kind of curious. No, that's just a hole over there. There's a whole cluster of acid spitters, but the distribution does seem to be quite different here. But yeah, I'm going to head back up and actually refine this iron ore. See what it looks like, or if it's just a bug or something and it actually gives me titanium or something like that, because it looks like titanium. Maybe it's just a placeholder model or something, because actually, while the ores are different, if you look at the copper and aluminium ingots, they're basically the same model, it's just different colours, so iron ore. I've not come across this before. That's why I'm feeling a bit confused right now. Especially since I don't actually need it to build anything, as far as I know. Unless I can use it for something, can I? Has it just been added or something? All these questions, I just don't know. So what is it going to give me? It smelt up all the hematite I've bought. There goes the copper. Oh, damn it all. It says it's ore, but I can't smelt it. This game is toying with me now, I can feel it. Might as well smelt up the aluminium since it's actually recharged. Okay. Hematite, iron ore, can't smelt it into iron, so it looks like an incomplete resource to me. Let's see if it's also not something you can trade for. It's like that astronium I came across on the previous planet. I couldn't find a use for that either, but Yeah. Iron ore, I was excited to find that, but it is an incomplete resource with no actual practical use at this point in time. Damn it all. That sucks. I was so excited to find it as well. It's like, oh hello, is this something new here? And it's like, nope. Nope, troll-a-lol, I'm just going to put it here to mock you. But it does seem that each world might have a unique resource. In this case, exotic world for iron ore, which is actually not exotic at all, but you know, it was astronium on the irradiated world, iron ore on this one. At least I think that's what's going on. Anyway, I am sorry about that. I wasted a little bit of extra time, a few more minutes here, just trying to do something like that, and it didn't pan out, so yeah. It seems they're here as placeholders more than anything else. But that aside, this has been Iron Mark 3. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the show. And next video, I will be continuing to push it underground just to get a better impression of what this world has to offer. Because the surface looks very good, but the underground is it's giving me mixed impressions right now. And then if I don't find anything, I'll probably just launch and head to another planet at the end of the next video. So, yeah. I'll catch you all some other time.